Hey guys, it's Jen, and I kind of just wanted to give you guys an update about what we're doing so far in the cycle. So on Friday, I had an ultrasound, and that ultrasound was of my lining and of any follicles that had developed. And so my lining was about 10.5. It may have been a little bit different than that, but I forget the exact number, but definitely 10 plus millimeters. And then I had on the right side, I had a 2.1 or 2.2, now I can't remember the exact, or 21 or 22 millimeter follicle on the right. And then also like a 13, I had a couple smaller ones, but that was a big dominant one. And then on the left side, I had a bunch of little ones and a 18 millimeter follicle on the left side. So what we decided to do was a HCG trigger shot, and I ended up doing that. So my appointment was at like 8 something in the morning on Friday, and I ended up doing the trigger shot about 6 in the evening before I went to work. So I did that on Friday, and today is Monday. I've been taking my temperature, and I think I'm going to stop taking my temperature because I'm going to microanalyze, and I think that's going to stress me out because I had a nice spike, and then the temperature dropped dramatically back to like my baseline normal temperature, so I'm kind of confused about that, and so I think I don't want to take them anymore so they don't have to worry about it. But that's where we're at now. So I have a particular date in my head of when I think I will test. I don't know. We'll see. You know, during the days that I should test, Jonas is going to be out of town. And so, you know, I kind of want to test with him here. But if I did, it might be too early. So I don't really know what I'm going to do. I have one a day in my mind, but I don't know if that will work out. So, that's all as far as our cycle goes right now. So right now, I'm just kind of hanging out and waiting to see what happens. What I did differently was I took, I was drinking 8 ounces of pomegranate juice a day. And for those of you who aren't caught up, I did 100 milligrams of Clomid this cycle. And, you know, Clomid can thin your lining. And I never had an issue with that before, but I was kind of worried that it might be an issue because I was increasing the dose of Clomid for our last try with Clomid. And so I asked people on Facebook and they said pomegranate juice. So I was drinking 8 ounces of pomegranate juice every day and it worked really well. So that was awesome. And then the only other thing that we have planned for this cycle is to do a progesterone level on next Monday. So I'll go in the afternoon and get that drawn. So that's all about the cycle. So if you have any questions, leave them below. And actually, I kind of want to talk about how I feel. So I feel like I am really excited, and I put a lot of I don't know, I just got my hopes up a lot during this cycle, in the beginning of the cycle, and now that, you know, the opportunity to catch the egg is over and I'm in that 2-week wait, I'm starting to get really doubtful and, I don't know, I just don't want to get my hopes up too much. So I'm kind of telling myself, not that it's not going to happen, but just to brace myself that it might not happen. That way, if it doesn't, that I don't get really disappointed, because in the past, you know, we've been trying to conceive for so long that I'm over it, you know, like, I don't usually test anymore, I just kind of wait for my period to start, and maybe I might test, but I really have not tested in a very long time, so, I don't know, this time is different, because we did a lot of things different, so, I'm nervous, and you know, I just don't want to get my hopes up and get my heart broken. So that's where I'm at. I mean, I'm still hopeful and still positive, you know, but at the same time, I don't want to get too hung up because I don't want to get disappointed. That's all I wanted to say. So, if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and I'll get back to y'all later. Bye. Deuces.